Hey guys, Joe back again, another episode of Getting Junk Done, and this is part two in the series of upgrading your headlight system on the 92 to 96 F-Series and Bronco Ford trucks. So what we're going to look at today is the headlight itself. In the previous episode, we've already done the wiring harness you see on the left. So let's take a look at the headlight itself. Here's a shot of the headlight already installed on the driver's side. This is something I've wanted to do for a very long time. Not only because I think they look a little better than stock, it's a more modern look, but there's a projector bulb inside and it's a one-piece design versus the three-piece design that we're used to seeing stock. Ever since I got the truck, I've never liked the headlights that came with it. The previous owner had gotten these headlights, put them in a box, and never installed them. And he removed the old ones, but never put the new ones on. So it was up to me to kind of figure out how to do that. And when he removed the previous stock original ones, there were broken fasteners and broken clips, and I just kind of had to rig them up. So they've never really sat correctly, and I've never even bothered to aim them either. So I'm going to do away with them altogether just to avoid the problem, and that's the biggest reason to getting this one-piece design. This new one-piece design does change the layout of the bulbs. In the upper left-hand corner, you're going to have the high beam. The bulb in the middle is going to be your low beam, and the bottom right-hand corner is going to be your turn signal. Everything else you see, including that ring around the projector for your low beam, are going to be LED running lights. Here's the rear view of this new one-piece design, and it will attach to the truck in the same exact points that the stock setup does, so there's no manipulation or modification needed there. There are covers for the bulbs, and this comes including bulbs, so you don't have to go out and buy separate bulbs at all. There are only three wire hookups, one for the headlights, and two others for everything else that are included. Now, these last two wire hookups were potentially the most confusing part of this install, but all you gotta really do is remove the bulb from the stock harness and slip these connectors into the bulb socket. These are designed to just simply replace the bulb, and they have all the wiring and everything possible already included, so the LEDs activate when the normal bulbs would have. Removing the old headlights is pretty much exactly what it sounds like. You find some screws, you find some fasteners, and you just remove them. You take everything out that's holding them in place, and it's really not that difficult. I did find that it's easier to go underneath the truck for one of the fasteners. It's just the best way to get your wrench on the fastener and just pull it out that way. It's a little bit of doing and it's a little frustrating, but everything does come out eventually. The headlamps themselves are separate from the bezel, the bottom, and the side lenses. So the headlamps are the last piece that comes out. And they're held in place with these clips that you see here. These clips are replaceable and they are available at the local auto parts store. I ended up just reusing two of them for the new headlights. And they fit perfectly, so the clips are reusable. After I got everything off of one side, I just repeated on the other. And here you see me taking them off of the driver's side. After I got everything off, I went back with some black spray paint and I blacked everything out that wasn't black, because in the end I'm going to paint this truck black and gray. I even did some on the upper radiator support too to help clean that up. And here you're looking at the new lens that's going in. I really like this style, and again, it's something I've wanted to do for a while. Those top two corner attachment points I just pointed to are where the clips are going to go. You see the wiring there, and the bottom attachment points just use the same nut that you took off the old headlight. Installation is just the reverse of removal. The new headlights slip right into the same spot, same attachment points and everything, and you're going to end up using those clips for the top two attachment points like I mentioned earlier. Now it's time to do the wiring. There are three plugs you need to worry about. The largest one is for your headlights, and this plugs in like you would any other headlight. This does not change. Plug it into the same spot you did on the stock headlights. The next thing is the turn signal. The turn signal itself should be left unchanged. You haven't done anything with that yet. Should still have a bulb and everything in the harness in the socket. The socket itself is going to kind of twist into the new headlight assembly and be held into place by like a quarter turn or so. And the location of this is right below the low beam bulb. So here in this picture, you can see it. It's that white circle right behind the headlight socket. If you've gotten this far, you're probably wondering what to do with those last two pigtails. The last two pigtails, honestly, are optional. They are only for the LEDs. Now, the LEDs are supposed to be used for parking lights or running lights, and they will plug in directly to the harness that's already on the truck. The harness on the truck should have two remaining bulbs, two on each side, and you're going to remove those bulbs and plug the pigtails into the harness. On my truck, I had one harness that had black tape and one harness that had orange tape, so I just made sure that I plugged the same plug into the right color on both sides. It'll make sense when you see it. So I used the blue plug onto the harness with black tape, and I used the other plug for the harness with orange tape. And I just made sure I did that on both sides, and it worked out perfectly. If you're not so lucky to have them color-coded like that on your application, just make sure you use the trial and error method. You can put the battery back in if you've removed it and make sure all the lights work the same and this and that. And if they don't, just switch them on one side so you get them to work the same. I really can't comment on the durability as of yet because it's only been a few days that I've had these on, but I can tell you this, the new headlight assemblies with the projector and the new heavy duty headlight harness that I installed in the previous video, with those two together, my headlights are so much brighter than they were before. So that alone makes me want to recommend at least trying this setup. Now again, in a couple of months, I'll probably put it up an update video to let you know how they're holding up and everything. But for now, I think they're a great setup and they work flawlessly together. Well, if you liked this video, please click like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, I can be found on Twitter @GettingJunkDone. Thanks for watching.